Now let's look at the SN1 reaction. And the SN1 reaction competes with the E1 and E2 processes. It does not compete with SN2. It is favored by a tertiary electrophile. In fact, this is required for the SN1 to accomplish, and an ionizing solvent. So we look at solvents which have hydrogen bonding. We could say water, methanol, so alcohol solvent, short chain alcohol solvents, amines, short chain amines are all ionizing solvents and can assist with SN1 reactions. Okay, and we can discriminate against E1 by lowering the temperature just a tiny bit, okay, in the reaction. So this is again different for every reaction, every electrophile, every nucleophile. Mechanistically, we get carbocation formation and this makes it slower than the E2 and the SN2 processes, and so it makes it where strong bases favor E2. The tertiary cation, or the tertiary position of the carbon, prevents SN2. But we get carbocation formation, and if we have a chiral center, we get slightly more inversion than retention of configuration. And this is due to the proximity effect. Okay, and so we'll look at that as well. So let's look at a mechanistic representation of SN1. And so let's consider this system. Okay, so what if we place this in an ionizing solvent, and let's use water, and let's let this stir. So over time, the waters will group around the iodine in all positions and tease away the leaving group. Okay, so we will ionize by teasing away the leaving group slowly using the delta minus on the oxygen, delta plus on the hydrogen. We can stabilize the charge of both the leaving group and the carbocation. So ionizing solvents are hydrogen bonders for that reason, and we end up with our planar carbocation. Empty p orbital, there's our intermediate, and we can attack from top or bottom with our solvent. So we show that by the leaving group leaving, and then if we have a solvent molecule, we can show it adding in this position. And so to complete the mechanism, anytime you have a protic solvent, we have the step where we have to remove the hydrogen using another one of the billions and trillions and moles of solvent molecules until we finally arrive to our product. And so the way we've drawn this, we had retention of stereochemistry, but it turns out, remember, our original compound had the iodine in the same configuration, okay, up relative to the three R groups as we've drawn them, so same there. However, that's the minor product. Because before the leaving group leaves, there are already nucleophile solvent molecules waiting to add from the backside of the carbon as the leaving group leaves. And so as delta plus begins to form on the backside of this carbon, we've already got nucleophiles that are ready to add to that position. Okay, so by the proximity effect, we end up with a major product of inversion, or inverted stereochemistry for the SN1. Okay, but we go through a carbocation and then we can add to the top or bottom major product inversion.